Hi. In this video, I add the seagull to the fisherman scene with the lobster trap. The adding of a seagull is something I've done since the 70s, nearly all of my scenes with fishermen, especially if they're in an activity with lobster traps or fish lines or boats or whatever. The problem I've had since many years ago was that many folk art galleries would find my work too detailed to be of interest. And many standard galleries would find my work too folk art to be of interest. So one of the things I've held on to is I've gotten a little more detailed and have a little more ability to create a proportional, more realistic figure. I cut the seagull in a very standard folk art-y caricature type way, so it's just to stand in recognition of what the work stems from. Hope you enjoy it.
First, I form a ball of clay in my hands, and then I shape it into a seagull. I do most of the initial shaping with my fingers. Checking to see how it fits with the carving. A little moisture helps in keeping the clay smooth, but it also helps keep it flexible. The base of the carving is quite dry now, so I moistened it quite a bit so that it wouldn't suck too much moisture out of the seagull when I added it. A little slurry to act as glue. And I stuck the little gull's feet to the carving. Now to add the body. Extra moisture will help to keep the seagull from drying out as I work on it. First, I'll begin shaping the feet. Even though this is just a caricature of a seagull, I still want it to come out looking just so, and I spend a fair amount of time playing with shapes and getting him just right. Time to shape the wings. And the tail, of course. I just want to indicate the outlay and shape of feathers. And shaping the underside of the wings. I'm not happy with how the seagull sticks out a little bit from the carving. I'm worried that after it was fired, this might be easily bumped and the whole sculpture would be damaged because the seagull's head would break off or something. So I'm going to realign it on the base and try and make it a little bit more pointing inward. And now I have to rework a little bit to get him looking just so again. Now I can do some shaping on the underside of the neck. As I move up to the head and beak, I find the head is getting quite dry, so I moisten it a bit to make it workable. I'm scooping out a little bit where the eyes go, but I'm going to give him bulgy eyes, so I'm leaving quite much clay there. The new angle of the seagull makes it a little bit hard to get at and involves a bit of maneuvering in order to reach the more difficult spots. A detailed brush helps do the final smoothing and shaping. Now I can get back to defining the underside of the wings a little more cleanly and sharply. I shape wingtips in order to place them over the existing wing shape and add a bit more detail to the little bird. Indentations are used to indicate upper feathers on the wings, and the lower feathers are defined with lines cut into the clay. And I'll repeat the same steps with the second wing. Just making sure the add-on piece ties in well with the underlying wing that I had there initially. A few final touch-ups and the seagull is finished. Thanks for watching.